the general public is completely in the dark about what they're exposed to. And it's amazing everything that's out there. And it, in a way, it's kind of stressful. My name is Kyle Doudrick. I'm an associate professor of environmental engineering, and I conduct research that is focused on emerging contaminants, microplastics, PFAS, and nitrate. You know, in a way, it's been interesting for me because I've changed a lot of my behaviors. You know, if I go buy a jacket and it says waterproof, the first thing I'm doing is I'm looking on the tag. You know, does it say PFAS free? And if it doesn't, I'm emailing the company. I'm asking them, do you use fluorinated products in your waterproofing agent? 6 of the PFAS are now going to be regulated under EPA's Safe Drinking Water Act. These things are very toxic. Some of them are known carcinogens. So we're developing a new type of membrane in collaboration with Professor Bill Phillips' lab in chemical engineering. And the hope or the goal is that this membrane would be able to remove PFAS down to the limits that we need in a cost-effective way.
Using these polymers in solution, I put a little bit of the polymer here and then pass the blade and it forms a thin layer.
Second project we have is related to pavement. Many of the military installations in the United States use aqueous film forming foams. And over time that has now leached out, the PFAS has now leached out of those pavements into the environment. So we're focused on looking at that leaching behavior as well as, well, what do you do with the pavements once they've reached their end of life? So we're looking at using incineration as a way to handle that pavement waste. All right, what we have here is a bench-scale incinerator that is simulating a full-scale hazardous waste incinerator called a rotary kiln. It will feed waste into the inlet side here, and that allows the heat to be transferred evenly throughout the waste. And in our simulator here, we can actually tilt this thing up so that the waste is rotating and then feeds out the outlet, and we can collect the treated waste at the end of the thermal treatment process. So we're using a very commonly available chemical. This is calcium hydroxide, also known as hydrated lime. Typically, PFAS requires around 1,000 degrees Celsius in order to break it down completely. And with the additive that we can put in, we are able to do this at less than 500 degrees Celsius. Using this hydrated lime in the incineration process is cheap, easy, already available. We can scale it up and, you know, it could be a really quick solution to handling a lot of the solid waste that are accumulating through PFAS contamination. I mean, at heart, I am an engineer, right? I'm here to solve the problems. I don't have a lot of control over what comes into my home, the unknowns, but at the very least, I know that once it gets out there in the world, I'm working on a solution to the problem.